Thank you. रूपं तस्या गजभुरिपुरीं मातुरीं गोष्ठवाटीं राधाकुण्डं गिरिवरमहोराधिका माधवासं प्राप्तो यस्य प्रथितकृपया श्रीगुरुं तं नतोऽस्मि वंशाकल्पतरुभ्यश्च कृपासिन्धुभ्यैव च पतितानां पावनेभ्यो वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो महाबदन्नाय कृष्णप्रेमप्रदायते कृष्णाय कृष्णचैतन्यनाम्ने गौरतिशे गुरवे गौरचन्द्राय राधिकायै तदालयै कृष्णाय कृष्णभक्ताय तद्भक्ताय नमो यं प्रव्रजन्तमनुपेतमपेतकृत्यं द्वैपायनो विरहकातरया जुहाव पुत्रेति तन्मेतया तर्वोभिनेदु तं सर्वभूतहृदयं मुनिमानुतु तवैवास्मि न जीवामि त्वया विना इति विज्ञाय राधे तं नय मां चरणं भक्त्या विहीनाय पराधलक्ष्यै क्षिप्ताश्च कामादितरङ्गम् मयि त्वां शरणं प्रपन्ना वृन्दे नमस्ते च चश्मा श्रीमद्भागवतम प्रथम स्कंध प्रथम अध्याय आई हैव टोल्ड द एसेंस ऑफ फर्स्ट श्लोक ऑफ मंगलाचरण ऑफ श्रीमद्भागवतम आई टोल्ड फाइव डिफरेंट मीनिंग्स ऑफ दिस श्लोक इन फाइव वेज नाउ सेकेंड श्लोक the essence of second shlok and third and we will begin dharma prajyat kaito atra parmo nirmat saranang satam vedyam vastvam atra vastu shivadam tap trayonamulanam shrimad bhagavate mahamuni krite kimba parai rishvara hrdye avaruddhate atra kritavi susvi tatkhana do shrimad bhagavat महामुनि श्रील व्यासदेव हैज रिटन सो मेनी पुराण्स इवन महाभारत इन दैट गीता गीतोपनिषद ही हैज डिवाइडेड वेदास इनटू फोर ही हैज कंपाइल्ड ब्रह्मसूत्र वेरी हाई क्लास ऑफ थिंग्स But he was not satisfied. And when Narad Rishi came, and he suggested to be in trance, totally surrendering to Krishna, and then in trance, you will have something that you will be satisfied, otherwise not. And he trance, he had Srimad Bhagavatam. And then he wrote. So, धर्मा प्रज्ञत कैतवो अत्र अत्र इन श्रीमद्भागवते इन दिस श्रीमद्भागवतम इज द लास्ट बुक ऑफ श्रीमद श्रील व्यासदेव इन ऑल अदर बुक्स लाइक ऑल पुराण्स in Mahabharata, like in Brahma Sutra. He had told so many things, but not sweet pastimes of Krishna. Very powerful, very sweet. In this, there is nothing mixture. In all Puran, there is something mixture. That in Golok Vrindavan, Srimati Radhika became angry and he gave some course to Sridham. And then Sridham also cursed him, her, and they came to this world. It cannot be. It is
impossible.
Impossible. So these are some things that in Golok Vrindavan they are quarreling and they have anger and lust and all so many things. Only to make realize of general people, not so much high, near about them, their intelligence. He gave all these things. But he told so many things that that are not true. Not true. Only he had told for beginners, as Swamiji has told something for beginners something, and for advanced devotees he had told something else. So we should try to reconcile all these things. So dharma prajyata kaitava atra, like for Harishchandra, like Dhruva, like also Prahalad, like Chitraketu Maharaj. He had told something, but not clearly. But in Srimad Bhagavatam, he had clearly told. What can lead us to Golok Vrindavan? Never he, in Srimad Bhagavatam, is not cheating us by anything, directly. He told in Srimad Bhagavatam, Guru na sasyat, swajano na sasyat, patir na sasyat, daivang na tasyat, jamo etya samupeta mrityum. A guru is not really guru. You should reject that guru. He cannot give love and affection for Krishna. You should reject him. A husband is not husband if he is not helping her wife for Krishna consciousness, really. We should reject. A guru, if he thinks that all these disciples are my property, I will test all these properties, like properties. They have no connection with Krishna, only connection with me. Then that guru is a reset guru, not guru. At once reject. Like Bali Maharaj rejected his guru. There are so many examples for this. If a wife is not helping his husband in Krishna consciousness, at once he should be rejected. If a son is not helpful and not helping his father in Krishna consciousness, then he should be rejected, like son, no relation at all. So, in the ground of all the relations, what is there? If they are helping in Krishna consciousness, then they are guru, husband, wife, daughter, son, father, friend, like this. Otherwise, you should reject. And if you are considering something, then you are deprived of Krishna bhakti. So in Srimad Bhagavatam, it has been told all clearly. Gopis left their all husbands, and they are superior most in whole world. So Srimad Bhagavatam is telling that, all these things. He has never deprived of not anything to cheat us. Nirmat saranam satam. What has been told in Srimad Bhagavatam? Nirmat saranam satam. Those who are out of envy or duplicity,
hypocrisy
and all other things. Never. Vastam, vedyam vastam vastu. Who is vastav vastu? Krishna is himself. Atvaya jnana paratattva. Anything is not free from Krishna, some relation with Krishna. Anyone is not dependent. Only Krishna is dependent. But sometimes he also not dependent.
Independent.
Sometimes he becomes independent of whom?
Dependent.
Dependent.
Of gopi. Brajavasis. Especially to Radhika. So, Srimad Bhagavate Mahamuni Krite Kimba Parairishwara. Nothing to read anything. Only hearing Srimad Bhagavatam. At once Krishna will be controlled. He will come. He is bound to come in devotee's heart. If there is, what? If you have honor for Harikatha, if you are hearing with honor, with strong faith that what is written in Srimad Bhagavatam is true to extent, only this thing should be there. And one thing, another also, not offending Srimad Bhagavatam, not offending Bhagavat, two kinds of Bhagavatam, Bhakta Bhagavat and
Granta
Bhagavat. Never. Then, if you are only hearing Srimad Bhagavatam with honor, at once Krishna will come and he will be controlled in heart. At once he is telling. What is the meaning of at once? Quickly. Quickly, quickly. At once. Don't disbelieve. Sukadeva Goswami, Ashuta Goswami, or Vyasdev himself. Don't disbelieve. How it will be? Krishna knows. Quickly, at once, he will come in our heart and he will never go anywhere. So eat, you should sit, eat with strong belief and a strong honor. By hearing, we will follow in our heart, in our activities, and Krishna must come. He is bound to come. Nigamakalpataro galitang phalam sukamukhadamridra sanjutam pivata bhagavatam rasamalayam muraho rasika bhuvibhavaka. Nigamakalpataro. Ved, Upanishad, all the Shrutis, Mahabharata, Ramayana, all are like a Kalpataru.
Desire tree.
Transcendental desire tree. And Srimad Bhagavatam, sweet fruit of all. If you are choosing, sucking the root of the tree, sweetness will not come. If you are sucking the leaves of tree, the branches of tree, sweetness cannot come. Even you are sucking raw fruits, green, even it will not come. When it is pure, matured, and has
ripened.
And some cooks, parrots, attracted with that fragrance. And if you have given some
beak,
and it will be so tasteful. So, all the Vedas, Upanishads are like tree. You can suck them, but no sweetness. Even Ramayana, Mahabharata, no sweetness. Even Purans are the same thing, no sweetness. Even you are reading Srimad Bhagavatam yourself, no sweetness. Why? When there is something in their mouth, that is something. And when they will give that in the throat, oh, it is very tasteful, very tasteful. And that is why it has been told, Ja Bhagavata Pada. I know that so many devotees reading Srimad Bhagavatam. Shankaracharya also reads this. Do you know? All the renounced order sannyasi of Shankaracharya, they read Mayavadi, they read Srimad Bhagavatam. Without their business cannot go out. So they read Bhagavatam. And they know more than us, very, very learned. They can do meaning of one word, hundreds of times, like Sarvam Bhattacharya. But they don't follow. Why? Because they don't hear from any realized Vaishnava, Rasik and Bhav. So it has come from Krishna in Guru Parampara. Guru Parampara. Sukhdev Goswami, who is Sukhdev Goswami? He is the parrot of Srimati Radhika. I have told so many times. And he has seen all the pastimes of, and tested the pastimes of Krishna. With his own eyes, with his own senses, with all his intelligence, everything. So anyone who has not read Srimad Bhagavatam from such a high class of Rasik and Bhagavata, in the line, this line, he cannot explain Srimad Bhagavatam really. We are explaining anyhow in that line, but not that thing will come. That nectar will not come. So if anyone has not come in this process, and he has not read Srimad Bhagavatam in this disciplic line, and he has not become a Rasik and Bhav, he cannot touch Srimad Bhagavatam, he cannot explain. Though he can utter words, no harm. And some explanations immediately. But the fruit will be not like as Sukadeva Goswami did to Parikshit Maharaj or others. They cannot do. But if anyone like Sukadeva Goswami, they have read Srimad Bhagavatam with Gurudev. And they are Rasik and Bhagavat. But they cannot explain it. Why? When will come to explain anything, they will remember Krishna pastimes and at once they will be infant. They will be like, but unconsciousness. They cannot. If Krishna will come and he will try to explain it, he will be the first person that he will be infant. Like Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, never, he could not explain himself. He wanted to hear from sometimes to from Garadhar. You know? He cannot tell. And if Radhika, even first word, Janma Dasya Ja, if he will see, will hear, what will be? He will remember Krishna. And at once he will be. She cannot do. Gadadhar Pandit also always weeping, weeping. But there was something. What? If Radha and Krishna had done some special mercy, like they did to Sukhdev Goswami,
that you should remain in this world, we are going. And you should be for some time in this world. And a special mercy we are giving to you that you can explain Srimad Bhagavatam to us. You will not be faint. That maybe chance, that a chance will come then when you will remember me or Radhika in Bhramar Gita or anywhere. Or in Ras, you will remember. But try to pass away that subject. Don't utter the name of Radhika and me in these cases. And try to subside. And a special mercy will come from us that you can explain Srimad Bhagavatam. Otherwise, it's very difficult. Very difficult. If he is not Rasik, who can explain Srimad Bhagavat? Because Srimad Bhagavat is Rasa himself. Brajendra Nandan is himself a Rasa Swaru. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, like himself a Rasa Swaru. So it is very hard. We can explain some lens. And you can imagine that if in semblance something is like this, then when some Rasik and Bhav Bhakts, like Gadadhar Pandit, like Raghunath Bhatta, like Rupa Goswami and others, Sanatana Goswami, they are explaining Srimad Bhagavatam in such a way. If you have read Srimad Bhagavatam Bhagavatamrita, you can imagine something. Otherwise, you cannot imagine. For this is like a treasure, very high class of treasure, transcendental treasure, more than what Chintamani. What? No. Desire stone. More than that. Anyone cannot compare. Those who are comparing like this, oh, they are foolish persons. You cannot compare Srimad Bhagavatam from these things. Those who have no taste in Srimad Bhagavatam like this, Sukhdev Goswami has told for them, 10th canto, first, Nivatta Tarsai Upagiyamanat Bau Sadhat Sotri Manobhiramat Kauttam Slok Gunanubadat Vrejjet Vinapasuknat. Those who are thinking only problems for these worldly things. And they are giving up Srimad Bhagavatam here. From any devotee who has left this world, no worldly any desires. And he is in the line of Sukhdev Goswami, in the line of Prabhupada and others. If he is not desiring to hear all these things for any worldly problem, oh, he is like what?
Butcher.
More than butcher. So we should take all these. These are only the Mahaushadhi of this world.
Medicine.
Panacea. Of the earth. It will not go in vain if you are hearing anyhow. If you desire or not, but you are hearing with Shraddha, then this is medicine also, and also very sweet like nectar.
Diet and medicine both.
So, those who are not hearing, they are like bhuchat. Or killing themselves, not bhuchat, but other animals. Both. Killing other animals also and himself. That kind of thing. And her whole future is blocked. Also, the nehamadam, nidehamadam, sulagam sukalpam, mayanukullin navasvate vitam puman bhavabdim nataresa atma. Again, it has been so many times. Words have been said. But even we worldly purush, like Bhuchar, cutting yourself. Oh, it is very good to cut, but to not to hear Srimad Bhagavatam. You should not be. So, Nigama Kalpata Rurgalitam Phalam Sukha Mukhat Amrit Drasam Jitam. He brought it from Goloka Vrindavan. It was the special parrot of Srimati Radhika. That is, he knows so many more things. If he was a parrot of Krishna, oh, he could not, would not have known the heart of Srimati Radhika. How Srimati Radhika is feeling happiness in the meeting of Krishna. Always parrot is with her and she knows everything. What happiness. And Radhaya Pranay Mahima, he knows. How Krishna beautiful in four qualities, how sweet. Oh, he knows because he is the servant of Srimati Radhika, he knows. And what happiness he, Srimati Radhika, tastes, also he knows that parrot. Not like Krishna, that Krishna wants to. And that is why he had to stole away the heart of Radhika. But these parrots have nothing to stole because he is always serving Srimati Radhika. He knows everything. He is a Rashi. He is a Bhavu. So he knows better than what Krishna knows. That is why Krishna deputed him to be in this world and to manifest this Srimad Bhagavatam. So you should try to hear this Srimad Bhagavatam with great care, with great honor and strong belief. Oh, I will have nothing to do for my going from this world. For mukti, salvation, and for that bhakti. Everything will come automatic by hearing. Krishna has promised that in the form of Harikatha I go in the heart, enter in the heart of devotees. So this is very powerful. And then I manage everything. You should not be worried for this. So he had told that, oh, for whole life. You should see Srimad Bhagavatam. He has not told that you should read. Anywhere he has told that you should go and read Srimad Bhagavatam? Never. By reading it will not come. So we should hear. Also for Harinam, same thing. First you should hear Shravanam, then Kirtanam, then other things. In Srimad Bhagavatam also it has been told. Oh, first Harikatha, listen Harikatha. And then you should be mature to tell Harikatha. Otherwise, your explanation of Bhagavatam or everything is like zero. So, after this, he heard the question of all the rishis. What question? Punsam ekantatasya tannasansatam arhasi ato sadho atra jatsaram samudhitta manisya pruhina sattadhanam jenatma sampasya. Tell me the essence of all the epics, Veda, Upanishad, Bhagavata and Srimad Bhagavata also, that by which following our atma, our soul will be
satisfied.
Will be happy. Also something more meaning. Jenatma samprasidati. Atma here, Atma of Atma is himself Krishna. If Krishna is satisfied and he is pleased, then everything is pleased. So we should try to please Krishna. Then our soul will be automatically so much happy. And if you are doing all things to please your self, Atma, your soul. Oh, Krishna cannot be pleased. and you cannot be pleased. So best process to please Krishna by your all activities. And then you will see that, oh, myself, my Atma is also, others Atma are also so much happy. Now he is telling, Shabai punsang paro dharmo jato bhakti radhakhaje. How Sukhdev Goswami was a parrot and how he came to this world and told Srimad Bhagavatam. I have told so many times. So nothing to tell here. We are going to this subject. Shabai punsang paro dharmo jato bhakti radhakhaje ahetukka vyohita ja bhakti pushottame. Oh, certainly, certainly, that is high class of paro-dharma, transcendental religion of all. What? To serve adhokkhaja. Who is adhokkhaja? Out of sense. Who is Krishna himself? Vrajendanandan Shyam Sundar. If you are doing causeless bhakti to him, and ceaseless, causeless and also without a stopping, uninterrupted, slow like you are doing bhakti. Not like that, oh, in morning I do something and after that I went to job and I forget all this. And in evening when I return, then I remember something. Om Bhur Bhuvaha. Krishnaya Swaha. And then again, you are taking prasadam and then. Now, uninterrupted flow, like a stream, like Ganges River, all this. This is high class. Dharma sunishita punsang visvakshen kathasuja notpadyadi jatiryating samay evahi kevalam. If you are also chanting, remembering, sometimes you are worshipping, sometimes doing your Trid Sandhya, Gayatri Titans. But you have no taste in hearing pastimes of Krishna, hearing from Mahabhagavatam. Then your chanting may go away very quickly. If you are worshipping, your worship may go. You are serving your Gurudev and devotees, then it may go away very easily if your hearing is not strong. You will be very weak very soon, and then we will think that I should return to my home, I should marry, and then we will make money, and then a golden deity will be there, and we will serve all devotees, always reading Bhagavatam and giving. You will be weak, and then you will go for it. So, dharma sunishtitam, visvakshenu katha sujaha. Those who have very strong faith in hearing Srimad Bhagavatam, taste some. Try to create case, taste. How it will come? Oh, comes hearing. If I have no taste in chanting name, oh, hearing, chanting, hearing some glories, that is it. But you will have to be in a high class of association. If that association is lacking, that you cannot develop your Krishna. And then we will begin. Then we will think, what? Very big problem. Now Maharaj is here, like Swamiji was here in this world. And then we were very happy and we were very enthusiastic, doing this, that, always. But when Swamiji went, then very big problem came. So so much sannyasi went down, brahmachari left. I think that most of you were brahmachari at the time of Swamiji. I know most of all, not married at all. And when he went, oh, then you become weak and you made married and children and you made a samsara of Gita. So now you can also think this, that Maharaj is now here and they are very inspired and going, after Maharaj, what will be? Then the same thing will come to us. We are also like that. We were serving our Guru then, and he departed from this world. We are here, like him. So try to be like this, always chanting remembrance of strong belief like us. I'm not high class of Vaishnava, but yet, I have so much strong faith and belief. Hearing Harikatha from Guru Parikatha. So, never be have any problem for future, like animals. Never be. Have faith, what Guru has given in our heart, not for problem. He has given everything, but now you'll have to protect it, and to sprout it, and to nourish it. Then you'll see everything realized. So no problem at all. Then he told that the story of Narada. Without the help of transcendental guru, high class of guru, any man cannot develop all these things. If he has guru, but he cannot help, if he is not helping. He had not served internally to his Gurudev, and he is not inspired, and he is not enough strong. He has no faith. He cannot help his disciples. So he gave first Sukadeva Goswami the life history of Narada. At first Narada was the son of Brahma by mind, by?
Throat.
He came from the throat. Means, in throat there is word, especially transcendental word. So, Narada is the manifestation of word. What word? Brahma Shabda. Brahma. That why I explained yesterday. That Shabda Brahma. What is Shabda Brahma? Krishna himself. So he is told Bhakta Avatar, Bhakti Avatar. The what?
Incarnation of that house.
Devotion. After that, how he came? In a very low class of family. Very low class. His mother used to cook here and there, not cooking, making
cleaning
here and there. At that time, Narada was of 5 years old only. 5 years. And at that time, Sanandan, Sanak, Sanandan and all four, with so many rishis, they came to in a village where he used to live with her mother. And with a very honor, he used to serve them. What serving? Oh, bring my lota, bring my dhoti, kamandalu, and you can come with me when I'm going to bath in river. He used to do. And luckily, one day he took some remnant of that rishi which was in their leaflet, and he took something. And as a result, what became? Vaishnava pada dhuli, bhakta pada jal.
Bhakta pada dhuli ya bhakta pada jal. Bhakta bhakta says teen sadhana.
Teen sadhana. You should have a strong faith. If you are chanting so much and doing all these things, reading Bhagavad, it will not help you so much. But if the remnant of any high class Vaishnava, remnants are quite this nectar and prasadam bowl. The dust of the lotus feet of that Vaishnava and water which has been washed his feet. That if you are serving with honor, not possibly like doing quarreling with rest him and rest taking. Rest. You fell flat that Vaishnava and forcibly you take. Not like that. Then try to follow Narada. And he became very dear and near to the sense of. And how quickly his mother died, which was very attachment for him. And he left all these things and very easily he entranced, he saw Supreme Personality. And he advised that, oh, you should hear and go on chanting, remembering and telling my Harikatha to all. And a day will come when death will come and you will not die. You will keep your faith on the head of that death. And it went like that. And he had his own Siddha Deha, which is under all here. He realized his feet, that form, and by that form he used to go everywhere. In this world coming, sometimes in Golok Vrindavan, sometimes with Narayan and here. So without Guru, we cannot go up. And that Guru should be not like Kali Yugi Guru. Kali Yugi Guru cannot be. Only he thinks property. But we are property of Krishna. So Guru should give we and to in the Lord's feet of Krishna and Narayana. That is good. So these instructions are like this. We know in Srimad Bhagavat he told, or bhakti should be not like Dhruva. There was some defect. What was the essence of the story of Dhruva? To whom I told? To you? No. You should come and tell. In very brief. I will go quickly. I am coming to touch 10th canto. Because I have told all these things. So essence are only given. Kaha kya? You can take.
So in Srimad Bhagavatam, 4th canto, we hear the pastime of Dhruva Maharaj. The great sage Maitri Muni is describing the pastime to the great devotee Vidura. He explains that there was a king named Uttanapad and he had two wives named Suniti and Surichi. They both have different nature altogether. Suruchi is a very materialistic woman, always enjoying sense gratification. She also has one son who is named Uttam. And the other wife of the king is Suniti, who is of a devotee nature and very simple lady. And her son is Dhruva Maharaj. Once the king Uttanapada, he was sitting on his throne and Suruchi was standing close by, and her son Uttam, he was sitting in the lap of King Uttanapada, and king was patting with love and affection on his head and also smelling his head. Dhruv, who was also nearby, young child, about 5 years of age, he looked and he also became eager to come and sit in the lap of the king, who is his father. So when he attempted to climb in the lap of his father, Suruchi, who was standing nearby, she became envious and she checked him to climb in the lap of his father. And she said, "Oh dear child, your attempt to sit in the lap of your father will not be fulfilled because you have not taken birth from my womb, although you are son of the king. If you want to sit down in the lap of your father, or if you want to sit on this throne, then you must go and worship Narayan. Please him, take boon from him, and by his benediction, you should take birth from my womb. Then only your desire can be fulfilled, not otherwise." Dhruva Maharaj was standing and he noticed his father did not protest it at all. He was silent. The harsh words of Suruchi, his stepmother, pierced the heart of this young boy. He has Kshatriya blood because he is son of the Uttanapada, who is Kshatriya. So he became so angry. He started crying and his lips started trembling in anger. And he quickly left the palace and he went to his mother. Meanwhile, other resident of the palace has described the incident in detail to his mother. And when Suniti heard such a bad behavior of his co-wife, stepmother of Dhruv, then she became so aggrieved to hear. Her heart became so painful and she also started crying. She immediately took Dhruv in her lap and started pacifying him. And she said, "Oh Dhruv, listen, my dear child, you should never wish anything inauspicious or bad for others. Those who cause suffering to others, they themselves get reaction of those actions. I know only the Supreme Personality of Godhead, Vasudev. He can help you. He can fulfill your desire. And in the past also, your father, great-grandfather has done like that. They have pleased the Supreme Personality of Godhead and they have acquired. All their desires have been fulfilled. So you should try to please him." Hearing these words from his mother, the boy had strong faith to go and worship Narayan. And after keeping himself together, coming out of that state of mind, he fixed his intelligence and with resolute determination, he left the palace, left the house of his father and went out in the forest. And when he went in the forest, Narad Muni, he came to know about this wonderful attempt of this young boy who has come in such a young age to know, to achieve, to please the Supreme Personality of Godhead. So he approached this nice, gentle, tender baby boy and he kept his hand on his head and said, "Oh boy, see how wonderful this Kshatriya is. Why? Because he's so young, but he cannot tolerate a little bit of insult. And who did that? His stepmother, no one outside person. So the elders can say like this to the child, 'Why you are so disturbed? You should not be so much disturbed. And in this age, it's like a sport or playing, you should forget it immediately. And even if you feel insulted, then you should understand that this is part of life. Everything happens by the laws of karma, the will of the providence. Sometimes you feel happiness, satisfaction, and sometimes you're suffering and you're not comfortable. So you should go back. You should play. This is not the age for you to perform austerities because you don't know how severe austerities have to be performed if one has to please the Supreme Personality of Godhead. In the past, for billions and billions of years, many yogis have tried and they have failed. You will not be able to do so." But Dhruva Maharaj was least affected by the words of Narad Muni. Humbly and with a very sweet voice, he replied to Narad Muni. He said, "O great sage, you have given very wonderful instructions to me, but I must tell you that my heart is completely broken by the words of my stepmother. I must get a more important position, more exalted position than my father, and so exalted that no one else should have that in this world. So you please tell me, how can I fulfill this desire? You're so merciful." So when Narada Rishi, he saw the determination of this young boy, he told him the process, that how he can please the Supreme Personality of Godhead. He gave him the 12 syllable mantra. He told him, you should go in the forest of Madhuban. You should take dip in the Yamuna River 3 times, and after properly cleaning and sitting in Ashtanga Yogasana, you should meditate on the Supreme Personality of Godhead. He also told him the form of the Lord. He also told him the qualities of the Lord and told him all the process. So Dhruva Maharaj, after taking all the instructions of his Gurudev, he circumambulated him, and paying obeisances, he left to the forest of Madhuban. And there, exactly as his Gurudev has told, he followed the process. And he became very attached with the mantras. And gradually, he lost interest in all his external activities. He gradually reduced his eating, so much so that he, in the last month, was not even taking air. He was not breathing. And the situation in the entire planet became so disturbed that everyone, even the demigods, were feeling suffocated. They could not breathe. So all of them, they approached the Supreme Personality of Godhead, Sri Narayan, and requested him, "O Lord, you are our savior. We are all feeling this disturbance. You please rescue us from this troublesome situation." And immediately, Lord Narayan, he said, "You should be pacified. I'll quickly go and pacify this boy, because his severe austerities has created this havoc." So immediately Lord Narayan, he came to this young boy who was sitting in his meditation, and he was meditating on the beautiful form of the Lord, holding conch shell and club and all the 4 items. When Lord appeared in front of him, the form which he was meditating inside was disappeared. So his meditation broke. He became restless. "Where is that beautiful form I was meditating on?" And his eyes opened, and as he opened his eyes, he saw that very form of the Lord was present in his front. Now, young boy, what he can do? He immediately falls flat at the feet of Sri Narayan, and he could not understand what he should do. But seeing the position of the tender child, Lord Narayan, he touched his conch shell with his head, and as soon as the conch shell was touched with his head, all the Vedas and all the realizations and all the essence of all the Absolute Truth manifested in his heart. And immediately he stood up, and with folded hands he started glorifying the Lord with so many wonderful prayers. But with this knowledge he also realized what? That material sense gratification is useless. One can never be happy in this world. No matter, they can try whatever they can. What to speak of in this world, they can go to even higher planets like Lord Brahma, still they will not be satisfied. Only pure devotional service, unconditional, uninterrupted, as we heard just now, can please the Lord, and only by pleasing the Supreme Personality of Godhead, one can be really peaceful. So now he was crying that why I desired for all that material opulence. But Lord said, "Since you have desired it, so I must bestow this benediction. But you should not worry. You will not be entangled, and by my mercy, at the end of this going through 36,000 years of empire and enjoying all this material sense gratification, you will come back to me." But here, the teaching which we get from this wonderful pastime is that Dhruva Maharaj, he performed very severe austerities, and he was worshipping the Lord. His devotion was uninterrupted. Continuously he was performing, and he was able to take the darshans of the Lord. But what happened? He was desiring for a broken piece of glass. He made all that effort to achieve a broken piece of glass. But when he found a diamond, he could not get it because his purpose was not motivated properly. He had darshans of Sadguru like Narad. Who can be more pure than Narad? But yet, when Sri Narad Muni, he detected that this boy had a very strong Anya Vilash, desire to have so much opulence in this world. Narad Muni understood that even if I tell him, he will not understand. So he must go through this. So he told him that, okay, even if you want these things, you should go and worship the Supreme Personality of Godhead. But his bhakti is called Sakam Bhakti. He did all those devotional activities, but for his own desires. He didn't perform all those austerities for the satisfaction of the Lord. He performed all those things for his satisfaction. So the main teaching is that even if we are performing all the external limbs of the bhakti as we hear, but they should be properly motivated with only desire to please Krishna. There should not be no other desire. If there is any other desire, then we will not be benefited. And another point, what? That he came to his Gurudev and he spoke very honestly. He told him that I have come to you for this purpose. He did not cheat it. He did not lie. But if we are in the association of Sadguru and we may take the dress of a devotee, but we do not open our heart and tell our all problems to Sadguru, then how he will help us? So, if we become honest and sincere in our approach, then by the mercy of Sadguru, surely our all anarthas will go away and we can achieve our supreme goal, which is Anya Abhilashta Shunyam Jnana Karmadhyanavratam Anukulyani Krishna Anushilanam Bhakti Ruttama.
A high class of devotee like Narad, he initiated Dhruva. He has also initiated Prahlad Maharaj, you know. He also initiated Chitraketu Maharaj. But these three were in different category. If Guru wants to give the same thing, Golok Vrindavan, the service of Krishna, but if there is no past impressions, then he cannot give. He wants to give, but they cannot take. So, Dhruva Maharaj has no past impressions. He can take no air, no water for 6 months. Very hard austerity. But not the... He has no impression of high class of devotees before. So Narad Maharaj could not give. The Swamiji, Srila Prabhupada, Bhakti Vinod Thakur, he wanted to give all these things. And that is why Bhakti Vinod Thakur started Nagar Sankirtan, you know? Namahatta, that we are following somehow. Swamiji began, started from me. But he could not get them. High class of devotion to Radha and Krishna, like Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Even Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, to Black Krishna Das, Kala Krishna Das, he was with him in South India. But he could not. So it requires some impression of this birth and also. But if you will neglect to be the initiation of high class of Vaishnava and realizing all these things, even Gurudev wants, and he can do anything, but he will not break the process. He will not give these things. That is why he could not give to Dhruva. And he is still in Dhruva Lok, not in Goloka Vrindavan. You know the history of Devahuti and Kapildev. Oh, very essence of that teaching you should give. in a very few minutes. I want to finish all these things, 10th, 9th canto. You can be here, Noha. Interesting, very simple.
Om Agyanam Timirandasya Gyanandana Salakaya Chakshurandaditam Yena Tasmai Sri Gurave Nama. So the sages of Naimasharanya, headed by Shonaka, asked their guru, Suti Goswami, to tell them about the birth of Kapiladeva, the personality of Godhead, who appeared, who, although the personality of Godhead, and without any material form, assumes so many forms by his internal potency, who is his supreme will. So Suta Goswami related the story of how Kardama Muni was the son of Lord Brahma, and he was ordered to create progeny around the universe. So in order to fulfill this order, he did austerities for many, many thousands of years, maybe 50 or 60 thousands of years. Then Lord Vishnu appeared to him, riding on Garuda, very beautiful, bluish with forearms, and he asked Lord Vishnu for the boon to have a wife of equal disposition to himself. So Lord Vishnu told him, because you did bhakti to me, you'll get more than your expectation. Not only will I give you such a good wife who will be of equal disposition to yourself, but she'll be the daughter of the emperor of the whole universe, and she'll have so many good qualities, and I also will come as your son. So it came about that Kardama Muni married Devahuti, and soon after their marriage, she was serving him, and although she was a princess and the daughter of the emperor of the entire universe, she was engaged in great austerities, not at all caring about her bodily comforts, washing her hair maybe once a year, and becoming very lean and thin, not caring about her food, only serving her husband in his devotional service. So then she asked him for a boon. She said, I'm serving you so much, so I want to ask you for a benediction. I want children. So first they had 9 daughters by Kardama Muni, who was such a great yogi, powerful yogi, that simply by his will he was able to create a palatial city which flew in the sky, made of diamonds and rubies and ivory, and all the bedspreads were made just white like the foam of milk. Everything was gorgeous, enviable by the denizens of heaven even. So then in that palace they had 9 daughters who were later married to the 9 great sages, the sons of Brahma, and they also propagated the universe. Then Kardama Muni wanted to leave because he had given children, but Devahuti begged for one son. So Kardama Muni gave her the greatest of all sons, the personality of Godhead, Lord Kapiladeva. And then he left, and he glorified Kapiladeva. He met him just before he left and glorified Kapiladeva. Then Kapiladeva went back to the palace of Devahuti, and Devahuti requested her son that, I'm very much distressed. My mind and senses are so distressed by material nature. Only you can purify me and get me out of ignorance. So I'm a woman, I'm less intelligent. I can understand very, very exalted things by myself. But if you explain it in a very nice way, then I can understand. So Kapiladeva explained how there's 2 types of souls, the conditioned soul and the liberated soul. And the conditioned soul, although transcendental, he thinks himself a product of matter and becomes involved in lust, anger, greed, and so many inauspicious activities, which sends him to different hellish results. But if such a soul becomes pure by sadhu sangha, then he realizes his own transcendental nature, and he realizes that he's self-effulgent, although minute, and he becomes indifferent to all material things. Then Kapiladeva began explaining what are the qualities of the sadhu. Titikshava Karunika. He's very tolerant and he's very merciful. And he's equal to all living beings. He's the friend of all living beings. Suridam Sarvadehinam. And he has no enemies. Somebody may be his enemy, but he's not anybody's enemy. Just like Maharaj Yudhisthira is called Ajata Satru. So this sadhu is called Ajata Satruva Shanta. Even if somebody's his enemy, like Duryodhana and company were the enemies of Maharaj Yudhisthira, but even so, Maharaj Yudhisthira considered them as great friends. So the sadhu is Ajata Satruva Shanta, and he's always peaceful. He's never disturbed by anything material. And he's ornamented by these wonderful qualities, sarva, sarubhushana. So from this type of sadhu, one should hear about Krishna. Then there's a verse given by Kapiladev, which Srila Gurudev quotes so very often. If you want to know where it is, because it's one of the main verses that he quotes, it's Srimad Bhagavatam 3:25:25, very easy to remember. And this verse is, Satam prasangam mama virya sambhito. Bhavanti ritkarna rasayana kata tad joshanat asvapavarga vartmani shradharatir bhakti anukramishyati. So, satam means pure devotees. In the association of pure devotees, or from pure devotees, mama virya sambhito. Mama means my, and virya means my heroic activities. My heroic pastimes, particularly the pastimes in Vrindavan. Sambhido, one who hears such discussions. Bhavanti hritkarna rasayana kata. This hearing acts like rasayana. Rasayana is similar to the word that Gurudev used, maha osadhi, or a very great medicine. If somebody's suffering and he takes a tonic of ras and he feels so much happiness in transcendental association with Krishna, in any loving relationship, this is rasayana. When a pure devotee speaks Hari Katha, as Gurudev just mentioned, Krishna himself enters into the ears, and through the ears, he enters into the heart and washes away all bad things. Then tad joshanat asvapavarga vartmani. He goes very fast on the path of liberation, and Shraddha, Ratir, Bhakti, Anukramishyati. Then step by step, by hearing from such pure devotees, he achieves Shraddha, strong faith in Krishna, Sadhana Bhakti, then Rati, or Bhava Bhakti, and then Bhakti, meaning Prema Bhakti, and ultimately Braj Bhakti. So then Kapiladev goes on to describe devotional service, that such a sadhu, and everyone should be a sadhu, he's saying, because Devahuti is asking, please tell me what kind of devotional service I should do so that I can get purified and reach perfection. So Kapiladev said, do the kind of devotional service that sadhus do. That is, they're so absorbed in bhakti that bhakti dissolves their false ego. Just like, this is very interesting, just like the fire in a stomach digests everything. So bhakti, performed by anyone, dissolves the subtle body, the false ego and the mind. So one should engage in devotional service with his mind and senses, renouncing his family. That doesn't mean necessarily externally, but internally, serving the family, as Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur writes in his Sharanagati songs, that I take care of my family because they're Krishna's and they're engaged in Krishna's service. So renouncing attachment to the family, renouncing attachment to the body, renouncing attachment to the false ego, and engaging the mind and senses without personal motive in the Lord's service. Then the Lord began to explain so many complex and deep subject matters. He said, I will tell you that knowledge which cuts all ignorance. and that knowledge is the knowledge of my qualities. Then he explains Krishna's spiritual qualities, his spiritual form. He says that anyone who is meditating on my smiling face, he becomes free from all material attachments. He becomes indifferent, and no problems can disturb him. As Gurudev often tells the story of Jad Bharat, whose head was on the chopping block, and his head in a few minutes was going to be thrown into the fire by the dacoits, he was thinking, oh, I have such bad karma. So if I give up this body, which is the result of that bad karma, then I'll get a good body next time as a devotee. So he wasn't the slightest bit disturbed. So then Kapila Dev began talking about the creation, how that Lord creates the five senses, the five material elements, the five gross elements, five subtle elements, 10 senses, and ultimately the 25th element being time. And by the agitation of time, the whole creation comes from subtle elements to gross elements, starting from false ego. Then there's false ego in the mode of goodness, passion, and ignorance. Then Kapila Dev explains the qualities of goodness, passion, and ignorance, of the mind, and of the intelligence. So many subject matters. So I'll end here.
Everywhere we are seeing the necessity of high class of association. Also, Kapil Dev told to his mother, Satang Prasangamam Vidya Sampita. So, Sadhu Sangha, Sadhu Sangha, Sarva Shastre Kaya, Law Matre, Sadhu Sangha, Sarva Shastre. Even a moment, if he is in Sadhu Sangha, that it will not go in vain. But it would be with honor and great. Very strong belief, otherwise no action. So, with honor we should do, follow all these things. Gracefully he can. He should not be upset, otherwise he cannot be benefited. You know, Bharat was of very high class of Vaishnava. And he was going to attain Rati, even Nishtha Bhakti, he has crossed. Test in name, Harikatha, everything was there. So renounced he became. And then he came in Ashakti stage. And he left his home. Children's, wife, everything. And he was now renounced and came in a very dense forest. And he was alone. And he was chanting, remembering. But what happened? He was attached with a deer who was drowning in the river. He had left his children and wives and everything. There was no attachment, he has reached to Rati even. So you should also be very careful for this. If you are coming to this state, from there is a chance to go down. If you have not touched and chanting, remembering, there is so much chance because you are full of honor. So we should always be in association, high class. If Narad was there and he was with association, Bharat Maharaj there, that I think that this would not have happened. He would not have gone for three lives down, never. But there was no one there. So try to be always, even at the stage of Nishtha, Ruchi, also with high class of devotees, association. If there was some association, he could not have fallen down. And then, this is, he has some pity, mercy for that baby deer. And this is called Sattvika mercy. This mercy, this should be in devotees. But they should not be attached with that. He should have done. But he was attached. And his attachment for Krishna went down. And then he quickly, he came to death and only remembering what he became. He became deer. And he was very careful in second birth and also in third. And you know all these histories. So what is the essence of this story? That Sukadev Goswami tell to Parikshit Maharaj when he was going to die. You have come giving up your son, all kinds of attachment, and telling Harikatha to you. You should not be like Bharat. You should not attach. You should not give a moment for other attachment. So you should be like that. There are two things. First is what? That if Bharat, in his last days, at the time of death, he remembered deer and he became deer. So if anyone having so many dogs and they have so much attachment with dog, that it is certainly that he will be dog in next year. Anyone cannot check, stop. If he has any attachment with worldly anything, then he may come like serpents, tigers and bears, like horses, like anything. Even he can be like a very beautiful lady, though he was a male form. And he will be very lusty. It may be that if any lady is remembering any person, then he may be like that, very lusty. It may be. He may be like donkey because donkeys are so lusty. So he may become like lusty, like monkeys and lord, all these things. So don't do like this. From beginning you should try to always chant and remember Krishna. But not only Krishna. If you are doing like that, that you can emerge in Krishna. And you can be like Mayavadis. With devotees, you should remember from beginning. If Gurudev has given some idea to you, you should try to follow. Sometimes Gurudev wants to give so much things. He gives also. But no association. So he did not. Gurudev gives him everything in Gopal Mantra. In Kamagayatri he gives. Everything is there. But he is not qualified to know all these things. But if he is always in association of high class of Vaishnava, he will realize all these things. So, they can realize you, make you realize that in Gopal Mantra, it was given by Krishna himself to Brahma. Kamagayatri was also given. And by this help, they went to Goloka Vrindavan. They can go easily. Nothing to take anything more. So Gurudev gives everything, but we'll have to realize in association of high class of Vaishnava. So we should remember more than Krishna to Yashoda or gopis like Rupmanjari and others. Then we can serve Krishna in that way. There are so many things to tell about this. We should follow Rupa Goswami. That is why we are called Rupanuga. Oh, I know that all gives a jaya dhani. Rupanu Guru Bharga ki jaya. But he never knows that what is Rupanuga. We should try to know with a question that what is Rupanuga? What is the Raganuga? What is the Raga? What is Shraddha? What is Nishtha? What is taste? What is Asakti? What is Arati? What is Prem? What is Sneha, Man, Prane, Raga, Anurag? Then you will know all these things. The high class of association gives all these things. By reading Srimad Bhagavatam, you cannot do it. At anything. So, satang prasangamu brajyasam. Also, we can learn so many things from Bharat Charitra. Bharat was so renounced in third birth. He became Brahmin. He became totally like mad. He was not mad. Always remembering Krishna and other things. And he never associated with worldly persons. Never. But it is doubt that whether he has received this thing, same thing what Chaitanya Mahaprabhu came to give. Anarpit charing chirat karunya. Never. You are so lucky. More than all, Bharat Maharaj and all others, you are so lucky to have come to this this time, just after Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. You are so lucky, we are so lucky. But if you are so unfortunate that you don't want to follow all this, don't want to take, we want to take gold, we want to take some worldly reputations from Vaishnavas, some other things, but not this high class of things, love and affection of Krishna. I think Bharat Maharaj never attained this. He had received so much high class of knowledge. But had he received this, a drop of love of Radha and Krishna conjugal, he had never heard of this. Never, he had no chance. Chitraketu Maharaj, high class of Vaishnava. Prahlad Maharaj, to high class of everything, everywhere he used to see Krishna here and there. But has he any anugatya of gopis? Have he any taste or greed for gopis? Oh, never. Because he had no association of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and his followers. But he was so much fortunate. Neglect and don't misuse this time. Otherwise you will be self-cutter, butcher-like. Don't be butcher. Try to utilize. Today time is over. I wanted to tell some.
Maharaj, you're saying that it's very important to hear the Bhagavatam.
Yes.
But to read, it doesn't help us.
Never. You cannot hear the essence. What I'm telling now, I'm third-class bogus person. Even I'm telling so many things. And when more elevated person, Rasik and Vaishnava, will come and tell, and then how glorious it will be. You cannot imagine it. But we are so fortunate that we have come just after Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. So we are so fortunate.
But if we are unable to have such association, then at that time reading will do something?
You can be like Mayabadi, Karmi.
No, we are left with such association for time being, and then what should we do?
In the absence of this association, you need it. It will help. It will give something. If you are sincere and praying to Krishna, Krishna is so merciful, he will at once marriage all these things. You pray to Nityananda Prabhu, who is more merciful than anyone. Oh, please manage this. Give me so high class of association that I can hear Chaitanya Chaitamrita and Srimad Bhagavatam. Oh, be merciful. I depend on you. I'm giving up my whole heart. And you will surely manage. You have such a high class of strong belief on Nitya. Hare Krishna. And then, come on.
But on the other hand, in Brazil, when somebody asked you, what do you mean by association, you said it doesn't necessarily mean physical, but it can mean by heart. So how do you get to it? Because then you have to leave.
Tomorrow. If it is available, physically, then why you should bother for this?
They want to know what to do on June 10th when you go away.
Hello! Oh, Krishna will manage everything. Shorten. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna.
Krishna, Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare.